guys. Quick walk on the beach. It's not really quick. There's nothing really to do today that we want to focus on. I was going to go to a car show, but I'm kind of taking the day off. I'm kind of exhausted. Tomorrow's a big Mustang show. Going to do that. But for right now, we're at Latigo. We're just going to enjoy ourselves. Found some really cool shells and stuff on the beach. I'll show you guys shortly. This on the blog quite a number of times because it's so spectacular. The sun is coming up right over here. These are some of the houses, quite nice. But this house in particular right here, this was Dick Clark's house. He was having it built and then he passed away, so it doesn't belong to him anymore. It might still be in the family, I'm not really sure. It's still brand new, really nice. Although I tend to like some of these other beach houses a little bit better. Those are pretty rock and roll. Kathy's in her homestead right here, along with the doggies. Found some good stuff on the beach, including this and lots of shells. Let me show you. Is an interesting day. We have this car that I'm driving from the Murphy Museum, 1938 Ford convertible. You guys have seen that here on the blog. Hold on a second. We're over at the English Car Company this morning just for a brief period. You know, it's an English car, cars and coffee. We're here early, so there's not too many cars here. There is, however, a really nice Jaguar right here. I'm gonna talk to the woman that owns that car. And then we're headed over to another show in Agoura. It's an all Mustang show put on by the Valley Mustang Club. We're gonna get to that.
What's up, gentlemen?
We're admiring
the Three Stooges. Enjoying this XKE, beautiful in sable. This car's got over 200,000 miles on it. I'm gonna tell you why. Hanging out with Daisy today at the English Car Company. You know, I love coming over here because you never know what you're gonna see. Mm-hmm. But Michael told me you have a pretty incredible story with this car that you bought new.
That's correct, bought it new in December of 67.
You bought it new. Why this car?
Well, when I was 15 years old, I saw one whiz by on Oxnard Boulevard, and I said, one day I'm going to have a car like that. So, of course, I had to finish high school. Then I went to college. When I finished college, I still wanted that car.
Right.
And I knew I couldn't get that car till I could get the down payment.
Right.
So for 2 years, I walked back and forth to work. This was in Little Rock, Arkansas.
That's commitment.
I left California, went to Arkansas to college. So I walked back and forth, and after the second year, with my mom's help, I had enough money for a down payment.
Wow.
And at that time, this Jag was $6,300.
Right.
And an American car was $3,000. So I bought my Jaguar, went back to Arkansas. There was not a car like that in the whole state.
That must have been interesting for people.
Oh, the highway patrolman would stop me, not because I was doing anything wrong, but they wanted to check out the car.
Yeah.
You know, it was in the 60s in Arkansas.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
And so I didn't want to have a gun because that was, and I was of color.
Yeah.
So I've got a German Shepherd and I trained the dog. So anybody who got close to the car, and the dog's name was Thunder. So Thunder would go off anytime.
Interesting that you had to buy a German Shepherd and you couldn't buy an English Shepherd. Friend, because we are at a Ford Mustang show put on by
the Valley Mustang Club.
Right. Which, how many people are in this pub?
Right now, our membership's about 50.
Okay. There's more than 50 cars here.
There's more than 50 cars. We've got about 75 cars in today's show.
Okay.
This is our 16th annual Stampede in the Park.
Wow. But it was in a different park before.
It was. It was at the Rancho Simi Recreation District offices in Simi Valley.
Yeah.
They since sold the property, but offered us this amazing location.
Wow. With the Mustangs, it's an incredible brand. Always has been. And, you know, a lot of these guys could answer this question in a very similar way. I want you to dig deep, brother.
Okay.
Why this car for you? What is it about the Mustang that connects with you on a guttural level?
Quite honestly, I've been a Ford guy for many, many years. When I got my Mustang, I chose the Mustang because of not only the iconic brand of Mustang, but the company behind it, Ford Motor Company. During the recession and after 9/11, when all the major car companies made decisions to take government funds, Ford was the only one that didn't do it.
Yeah.
And that really resonated with me because they were going to survive without it.
Yeah.
And they have. And you can see here, 1964, when they released the Mustang, it's a car that really connects with people, I think, like no other car out there. Mustang owners range in age from first-time drivers, 16 years old, even younger, that get their first car, to folks that we have a gentleman comes out here, he's in his 90s. I worked for a Ford dealership for about 25 years, and I ordered that 2013 GT500 for a very, very good customer of mine. And he said, order it the way you'd want that car. So I had free reign. I went ahead and ordered it.
Yep.
About a year later, he calls me, said, hey, I just had knee surgery. I can't drive the car anymore. Do you know anybody that might want to buy it? And I said, got an idea. Valley Mustang Show here in Agoura Hills, somewhere. I don't know where exactly.
Oak Park.
Oak Park. And you have a pretty gorgeous green Mustang behind us.
I love her.
What's the story with this car?
When I was 11 years old, my aunt left me in her will. My parents, good people that they are, would never touch the money. We moved out to Agoura, and I needed a car. And this is what I got. My father said I could have a Mustang.
Brand new.
Brand new Mustang, and this was my first car. 67 Mustang, 67. Stolen twice.
But you got it back because it was.
I got it.
It just
back.
Belongs
but
to you.
Boy, it wore my heart out.
Yeah, I bet. I bet. But I bet you've had some good stories with this car.
I do. I beat out a Porsche on the freeway.
Really?
Best story was when the detective called me and told me we have your car. That's the best story.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people can have other stories.
It's like a kid running away from home and then you find them.
That's right. And they said, we have your car.
Congratulations.
Thank you.